Hi, this is Jose Luis, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to write a console application in C# that is a WebSocket client, and then that it can connect to a WebSocket server and exchange information. And for this video, I'm going to be connecting it to the WebSocket servers that I have explained in the previous videos on this playlist, Fun with WebSockets, that you can check on the description of this video. So very simple. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to start Visual Studio, and I'm going to create a new project that is going to be a console application in the .NET framework. So I'm going to find the template console application, and I don't want .NET Core. I'm going to be working with .NET framework. Okay, I'm going to do that. I'm going to place this on my desktop, and then I'm going to call this project C# client, for example. And I'm going to choose the .NET framework 4.5 for no particular reason. It's just a very popular version. So, and I'm going to start my project. Okay. So I have my console application here and I'm ready to start. Now, the thing is, what we're going to do is .NET has some support for WebSockets. It's just that it's a little tedious to write and it's not a very gentle experience. So there's actually this one library for doing WebSocket communication in C# that is called WebSocketSharp. That is very popular, and I actually like it a lot, for example, personally. And I'm going to be using this library just because it makes things much easier. Okay, so in order to use this library in our project, so if you're interested in the library, you can come here, and there's a bunch of examples, and the documentation is also pretty thorough. You can use it in Unity as well, which is very nice. And it has some basic examples here. So what I'm going to do is, if I wanted to use this library in my C# console application, one thing that I could do is I could just go to the repo, I could download the source code, I could build it, and then I could get the DLL and insert that DLL, reference it in my console application. However, turns out that WebSocketSharp is available on the NuGet gallery. The NuGet gallery being Microsoft's packet manager for Visual Studio. So basically what that means is that in Visual Studio, we can just, with one click, we can just connect very easily to, we can just find this library, download it, and make it part of our Visual Studio project, which is what I'm going to do right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my Visual Studio project, and I'm going to click on the project, and I'm going to click on Manage NuGet Packages right here, I think. And then as I do that, I'm going to click on Browse, and I'm going to type here, you can see that there's a lot of libraries that are available. I'm going to type here WebSocketSharp. And let's see, WebSocketSharp. Okay. And then I can see that there's a bunch of them. Turns out that because it's an open source project, a lot of people have copied it and cloned it and uploaded to the repo. So I believe this one is the one, because that is the original one. So if we see the GitHub URL, is the same one as this one here. So I'm going to go for that. So I'm going to go for the WebSocketSharp non-pre-release whatever version. So I'm going to install that. It's going to ask me to, oh, do you want to install that? Yes, download it, blah, 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 whatever. And then I want to highlight this. So here is the project that I created. If I open it, you can see that I have a folder called packages. And inside of packages, now I have my WebSocketSharp, and I have the library for blah, blah, blah. So this is the DLL that has just been installed and referenced in my project. So that is a very convenient, a very easy way of managing dependencies in C#. So I'm going to close that now, and I'm ready to start writing some code. Okay. So what am I going to do? Well, the first thing I'm going to do is, as I typically do, I'm going to just read a key so that I stop the program, and then so that I can open a console application that is going to be, I'm going to dock it here in my, in this screen, and then now I have a console application that stays alive until I press a key. The first thing that I would like to do is I would need to incorporate this library into my code by importing the library and having it available in the scope of my program. So the way I'm going to do that is with the using keyword, and then I'm going to type here WebSocketSharp, and you can see that I already got the autocomplete suggesting me to bring in that library. And now the next thing that I'm going to do is in my code, first of all, I'm going to create an instance of a WebSocket client with this library. So create an instance of a WebSocket client. The way that's going to be is that the WebSocketSharp library has this class called WebSocket, which stands for a WebSocket client. So I'm going to declare a variable of the type WebSocket, and that's going to be a new instance of the WebSocket class. And the WebSocket class is asking me here, is asking me for a string, which is the URL of the server that I want to connect to. So here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to type the URL of the server. If you remember from previous videos, I had this custom simple WebSocket server that was living on Glitch, and that was written in JavaScript over Node.js. And this is one of the beauties of WebSocket or network communication in general, which is that you can connect and make processes that are written in different languages. You can make them talk to each other. So this server, if I click here on show in a new window, you can see that here I have the URL of my WebSocket server. So I'm going to copy this. I'm going to paste it here. And then I'm going to replace HTTP, which is the protocol, the standard protocol for websites. I'm going to replace it with the WebSocket protocol, because that's what I want to do. That's how I want to connect to this server. And then the next thing to do is WebSocket. I want to connect to that server. And then maybe what I want to do is I want to send a greeting message. So what I want to say is, can you send like a message, for example, saying hello server, all right? And then let's see if that works. So I'm going to dock this on one side. I'm going to bring this in here. I'm going to dock it on this end, and I'm going to keep the server. I have a lot of stuff going on, sorry. And I'm going to dock the server here because I want to see in my logs if there's any connection coming in. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to execute this, and you see that this WebSocket client started, and you can see on the server, you can see that there was a new connection, and that was there was a message coming in from the client, which means that the connection looks like it's working. And I'm going to press the key, and this is going to go. Okay, so this is working great. However, so far, what the client does is that it talks to the server, but the client is not still listening from the server. Remember, this is an echo server, and the server responds to the client with whatever it receives. So this client is sending a message, hello server. That message is being bounced back to the client, but the client is not doing anything. We're not seeing it anywhere because we haven't really written any code to handle the information that is coming, the messages that are coming back from the server. The way we're going to do that is going to be very simple. We're going to be using a property or a pattern that is very common in C# for asynchronous stuff, for handling situations that we don't really know in time when are they happening, like for example receiving a message from the server. We're going to be doing that by using event handlers. What does that mean? What that means is that the WebSocket client that we created, if we type here, it's going to have a bunch of methods called onClose, onError, onMessage, onOpen, which are similar to the event handling that we did in the previous videos with JavaScript. What these are is they are event handlers that I can subscribe to. What that means is that to these events, I can attach functions that I want C# to run anytime the client closes, every time there's an error, or every time I receive a message from the server. So for example, if I type onMessage and then I type plus equals because I want to add a new event handler to this event, And then you see how the Visual Studio is already giving me an autocomplete press tab to insert. I'm actually going to do that. And you're going to see that Visual Studio was actually really nice at creating this new private static function called WebSocket on message. And then with the two parameters that this function is going to receive from the on message event handler, and to attach that function to the event. What this means is whenever there is a new message, C# will know that it has to execute this function and to pass it two objects. One, the sender, so who is sending this message, and another one being all the arguments that are contained in that message, which by the autocompletion is automatically called E, as in event. Okay. So what can we do with this? Well, what I can do is something very easy. For example, what I can do is I can take that message and just print it to the console. So for example, I'm going to say console.writeLine, and I'm going to print received from the server. I received this thing. And that thing is going to be, if I type E dot, I'm going to get access to all the properties and all the functionality that the event contains. And the main one is going to be a string that is called data. And the data is just going to be a string representation of what is coming from the server. So I think I'm going to dock this here, and I'm going to try connecting again to the server. Oh, and I see I'm being hacked by some of the live viewers that are watching this tutorial as I am recording it. So I'm very happy about that, actually. So I'm going to execute the client now. And then you see that I just got a connection to the server. I got this hello server acknowledgement, and then the server bounced that message back. And now on my client, I have a message received from the server, the hello server string. All right. Which means that at this point, I think the client hello from pcamp. I'm going to do that again. And I just connected hello from pcamp, you know, this, so this is working great. All right. So I think with this, we are pretty much done with writing a WebSocket client. So this works and this does the trick. However, there is a slightly more, I could call it elegant, but there's a slightly more efficient way of writing this, because it turns out that when you create WebSocket connections, because WebSocket is designed to maintain that open relation, that open connection with the server, sometimes if the program doesn't close properly, if the execution, something goes wrong with the execution loop, then maybe the connection may stay residually open and not close properly. And that may lead to problems connecting again, et cetera, et cetera. So it's actually good practice to scope in the creation of these kind of objects to make sure that if something goes wrong, they are properly disposed. And by disposed, what I mean is being properly closed and being properly removed from memory so that there's no problems again reconnecting or creating more clients. A way to do that in C# is by using the using, which is very confusing. I'm not sure if it's a function or a clause or what is it called. It's a keyword it looks something like this. So we can type using, all right, open and close parentheses and open and close brackets. And then anything that we declare in the parentheses will be scoped within this block and will be disposed whenever this block finishes executing. So what we can do is we can take this, the creation of the WebSocket object, and write it inside of the using parentheses to make sure to tell, to make sure to indicate to C# that this is what we want disposed, removed once we finish with the code. And then we can just take all of this and paste it inside of the using block. Okay. So This is going to allow us to connect to the server to do the same thing. And functionally, it is exactly the same. It looks exactly the same. It's just a bit more optimal. Create a scoped instance of the WebSocket client that will be properly disposed. All right. If you don't want to do it, that is fine. This is just a bit more efficient memory-wise and connection. It's safer to do it this way, if you will. Okay. All right, cool. So now let's be a little playful, right? So remember how in my previous examples, I had this code that I had written, that it was a P5 sketch that was connected to that same server and that I could control with a circle, right? And then now that my server is connected to my client is connected to the server, you can see that I'm also listening to all these incoming connections to all this incoming data that is coming from the other client. Now, what I would like to do is I would like to use this data to do something funky with, or to draw something on the screen. But in order to do that, first I'm going to have to deserialize this information into numbers that I can use for drawing on the screen. So that's what we're going to do in the next video. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to take JSON information in C#, deserialize it, and then use it for drawing something on the screen, for example. So let's take a look at that.